All of us have made a number of agreements about how we will go about our life. We've made agreements with our parents, partners, children, friends, with our gods, with society more broadly. And of course, the most important agreements are the ones we've made with ourselves. All of these agreements we have made guide our personality. They tell us who we are, what we believe, what we feel, and how we behave. In most cases, however, all of these agreements were not consciously chosen. Don Miguel Ruiz says that like farm animals, we have been domesticated from childhood. We were rewarded or punished based on what we did or didn't do, and this molded us to become who we are today. This book shows us that it's possible to break some of the old agreements we made that are no longer serving us, and instead create brand new agreements that we are going to consciously choose and uphold day in and day out. Whatever our own agreements may be, Ruiz suggests that based on Toltec wisdom, we should all make the following four agreements. Here are the top seven lessons from Don Miguel Ruiz's The Four Agreements. Lesson 1. Become an inner warrior to reclaim your happiness and sanity. Don Miguel Ruiz says we must all become warriors like the Toltecs. Not with arrows and spears, but with our minds. The Toltecs already knew that every human being must eventually fight a battle inside ourselves. This is a battle against our old conditioning, such as all of the unhelpful beliefs that we were brainwashed into believing when we were still far too young to argue. Imagine if everybody's skin was covered in painful wounds. So every time two people get close to each other, their emotional wounds rub and make both of them suffer tremendous pain. This is exactly what's happening in our world today. But Don Miguel says there's a healthier and better way to live, a way that gives us peace and freedom to be who we are. This way starts with the four agreements. 1. Be impeccable with your words. 2. Never take things personally. 3. Don't make assumptions. 4. Always do your best. Lesson 2. Wake up to how we're all domesticated into rules and false beliefs. Ever noticed how happy we often looked when we were kids? Have you ever adopted a puppy or know someone that did? Then you know that the puppy must be trained, or there will probably be poo on the walls. And just like puppies, human children also get domesticated, often using reward and punishment. Do what daddy or mommy say and they show you love. Break their rules and they love you less, making us feel alone like we're lost in a dark forest. This is what the author calls the process of domestication. Our parents, religions, culture, and schools teach us the rules that we must follow to become good and valuable people. Lesson 3. Never blame, judge, or go against yourself to live in peace and love. The way we talk to ourselves is what creates our inner experience of the world, an experience that can either be a heaven or a hell. That is why the first agreement this book talks about is to be impeccable with your word. But what exactly does this mean? Well, the word impeccable means perfect, so we should be perfect or flawless with the words we use to talk to ourselves. Lesson 4. Understand that everything people do is about them and not you. Why do we feel bad when someone attacks or insults us? Because we feel their words say something about us. The truth is, anything people say about us is really a reflection of their own dream, their programming. That is why the second agreement in this book is to never take things personally. Everyone is living in a unique dream. It is a dream created by the judgments, rules, beliefs, and opinions they were domesticated into. They never had the choice how they were trained. But the main point is, the world someone else lives in is completely different from the world you live in. Lesson 5. Don't assume people see the world how you do. To live in the world, we often must make assumptions. For example, we habitually assume that cars will always stop at red lights. That is why we begin walking across the street even without looking, if it's safe to cross sometimes. But while assumptions may serve us well for simple tasks like this, they can also be harmful to our relationships, because relationships can quickly degenerate into fighting and misunderstanding when people make assumptions. That is why the third agreement is that we don't make assumptions. Lesson 6. Take action while always doing your best to say yes to life. Action is our way of manifesting our intentions. Action is how we express who we are in this world. When we take action, what we are really doing is saying yes to life. That is why the fourth agreement is to always do your best, and we can never do more than our best. If we recognize this, then we'll enjoy taking action more. We must focus on doing our personal best, rather than judging ourselves to others. Lesson 7. Forgive others to set yourself free. The only way to heal our wounds is through forgiveness. Don Miguel says to forgive whoever wronged us in the past, not because they deserve to be forgiven, but because we deserve to live with love and peace. As long as we hold on to resentment and anger, that won't ever happen. In conclusion, after making a vow to follow the four agreements, we must realize that obstacles will arise from time to time. We should be prepared and should not let them derail us. We must remain in the present, and should we fail, we should look to the next day to succeed. Can you follow the four agreements? Let us know in the comments section. Thank you for listening. Please don't forget to like and subscribe so you don't miss out on my new content. You can also get a free copy of the audiobook by clicking the link in the description. Until next time.